Hello, my name is Emma Butzler, and the book I decided to read was Inconspicuous Conception by Tatianna Schlossberg that was published in 2019. Tatianna Schlossberg is a climate change writer for the New York Times, along with other newspaper outlets. So the book was primarily about things that we use and consume on a daily basis, things that we interact with that we don't really know contribute to climate change and greenhouse gases. The author talks about four main things: the internet and technology, food production, clothing, and fuel. And the author takes one of these topics in each of her sections and really elaborates on them and talks about the things that the readers might not know. The book was also written in a first-person point of view using words such as I, me, and we, and this gives the reader a more personable sense and brings the reader into the story. This was obviously intentional by the author because she was able to add a personable touch to the narrative and add her sense of humor throughout the story. This was also very essential to the book's message because the author reflects the reader's actions and lifestyles choices, and she's able to tie them into the story by making the issues relatable. Although the book was informal, the author's use of statistics, facts, and widely known and respected research groups added to her argument, and she was able to gain credibility and trust with the reader. She broke down any data and made it understandable to the reader despite the reader not having any kind of background in that area. She explains any jargon that she used, and she makes the reader feel very comfortable with the information given. So I wanted to give a brief overview about each of the sections and how I thought the author appropriately talked about each issue. So the first topic I'm going to talk about was her first topic, which was the internet and technology. And I think it was very important to point out that the author started her book with this section. And this is primarily because everyone has it, everyone uses it, and our reliance on technology is incredible. When it comes down to it, most of us actually don't know much about the technology we use. For my generation, we were given iPhones in middle school, iPads in high school, and unlimited use of the internet. We grew up without seeing that evolution of technology that our parents saw. Therefore, we don't really think about the implications that come from the technology we use. So the author starts out by talking about the actual physical infrastructure of the internet, such as the wiring. And then she talks about how we use the internet now, such as social networking, Netflix, and online shopping. She goes on then by citing how the information and communication technology sector contributes to 2-3% of all CO2 emissions, which is more than air travel. She also talks about a study that was done that estimated one online video that was streamed resulted in 0.4 kilograms of carbon dioxide emissions per hour, adding up to 1.3 billion kilograms per year. And this is just video streaming. This quote was extremely important to get across to the readers to prove that the way we are living is very unsustainable. The author paints this broad, complex picture of the environmental implications that come from food production. She does a good job of covering a lot of cause and effect relationships that are related to agriculture. One thing she talks about is how the continuous use of the same soil makes the soil poor, which means fertilizers need to be used. The fertilizers then run off into streams and create dead zones that kill fish and loses biodiversity. The cycle the author talks about links the food production to other environmental damage that the author probably knows about but doesn't know the causation is from things that we buy in the grocery store. So the author further pulls the reader into the main message. The next topic the author talks about is fashion, which makes up for 10% of greenhouse gas emissions and intersects with a lot of other industries such as chemical industry, agriculture, transportation, and fuels, fossil fuels. The author talks about things like fast fashion, such as Forever 21 and H&M, and how these places quickly make products that are in trend and seasonal, puts them out into the store, and the turnover is so quick that they have to make new products to replace those products, so there's a lot of clothing wasted. I could be the reason that someone over in a different country is having health implications or has a birth defect. So the last section that the author talks about is fuel and how extracting the fuel causes a lot of environmental degradation in poor areas. And she also talks about how Uber and Lyft play a role in pollution, also traffic does. One of the big things I think she touches on is Amazon Prime, which a lot of us use Amazon, and me personally, I have Amazon Prime. And Amazon Prime, you expect a delivery in 2 days, and because of that expectations, trucks that are delivering a good are half full. Therefore, they're traveling all this way, and their truck isn't even full, so it's not efficient at all, and they're wasting a lot of gas on a half-empty truck. So, overall, the book's narrative is great at showing the complexity of all the things we consume and use in our daily lives. The author's structure of the book was very well laid out, and she used each section and related it to another section. Overall, there is no escaping environmental damage, and a lot of the damage is because of the system that was set up for us. The author points out that as a consumer, we should know a little bit about how our actions and decisions affect people on the other side of the world. With globalization, we transport our problems to other countries and therefore forget about the problem altogether. Schlossberg was able to bring the problem back to us and drive home the message that we, the consumers, are the problem in the climate change issue, and the issue is so complex that there is no one solution.